I'll never forget the first time I met Larry Mariottini. It was 10:45 on a Tuesday in 1972. I walked into the lobby of this very she men's hairstyling salon where I worked. He looked most uncomfortable. Someone had said to him, "You need Miss Fripp." He didn't know he needed Miss Fripp, but he was there. Now let's just look at that so we know when it is. It's very important we let our audience know if we're talking about the past, that it is in the past. Because I don't want anyone elbowing their neighbor saying, "Does she still cut hair? Oh, I wonder if she's looking at my hair. I wonder if she brought her shears with her." So when, where, now, I am not a speaker who walks as much as I used to in the early part of my career. Much of our movement distracts from our message. However, if you want to move, and I am not saying don't move, please, I'm not saying don't move. Be more strategic in your movement. So, of course, if you are walking into the lobby of your she men's hairstyling salon, that is a movement-specific phrase. So there's Larry. There he was. Larry Mariottini was a computer programmer for Levi Strauss. I guess you might say Larry was a nerd long before I knew what one was or dreamed I would want to grow up and be one. You cannot insult your characters who were going to have the lead role. Now, it's different if there is a persona that they are not going to meet that you can have a little fun with or you can insult. However, this is the star, and would you raise your hand if you consider yourself technical and somewhat nerdy? Good. Do you realize if you didn't show that you admired and had an obviously respect for your character, you are going to alienate those who consider they are more technical? Okay. I took him back to my booth. Now, this again is a movement-specific phrase. I took him back to my booth. I shampooed, conditioned, cut, styled, sprayed, and fluffed his hair. Now, in your picture, imagine if I was saying, I took him back to my booth and I shampooed, conditioned, styled, sprayed, and fluffed his hair. He really looked good. Now, you understand, you have been, even Wall, you have in your life been to a hairstyling salon. So you know if the stylist is working on you, they are working around the chair. They're not wandering around aimlessly. Do you realize if you are distracting, walking around when the audience has seeing you in one place, there is a disconnect. Larry walked out of my salon with a bag of shampoo, conditioner, hair spray, hairbrush. Never spent so much money in his barbershop in his entire life. He walked into the lobby of Levi Strauss. And all the women said, "Larry." He went home and his wife said, "Larry." Well, you'd imagine a couple of days of this positive response, Larry realized he did look good. And what usually happens when you improve one aspect of your life, appearance, or presentation, it has a tendency to spread. So Larry Mariottini joined a gym, started working out, bought some trendier new clothes, and started acting in a more outgoing way. So much so that Levi Strauss offered him a sales position even though he had no prior sales experience. Larry Mariottini turned out to be the biggest salesperson in that division. They cut his territory 5 times and he still sold more than everybody else. Now I know what you're thinking. This Fripp woman wants to take full credit for transforming this man's life, getting him a better paid job, and shall we say, more attention at home. Well, obviously, Larry Mariottini had something to do with this, but consider this. Every day, when we go to work, we can focus on what our job is or how we serve. I could have thought I have 16 heads of hair to cut. Instead, I chose to think I have the opportunity to positively impact 16 people's lives. 5 years ago, at District 4 Toastmasters Conference, do we have some friends from District 4? I keynoted the conference, and I told them the Larry Mariottini story. And after, in the break, a gorgeous, good-looking, red-headed district governor came up and said, after he got divorced, I dated Larry Mariottini. Do you know where he is? And I said, no, and I've tried to find him. I mean, Levi Strauss, HR department doesn't know where he is. I Googled, can't find him. And she said, I am going to track him down. And would you believe, as fate would have it, the next day, his kids put a Facebook page up for him. She tracked him down, we got reconnected, and I would absolutely love to tell you, Larry Mariottini is standing in the back of the room. I would love to tell you that, he's not there. I really would love to tell you, because you'd love to meet him. And you got some moves. However, what she did tell me was, he told me you really did transform his life. You cut off his Elvis Presley sideburns, which I didn't remember. Now, do you ever get a little bit nervous? Do people you talk about actually see the story the same way you did? But fortunately, she said, yeah, Larry Mariottini absolutely said, you really did change his life, and that was the catalyst. But the good news was, because I reconnected, see, now I am a lot smarter, fortunately, than I was in the 70s when I met him. Because now I said, Larry, can you tell me specifically why you as a technical person got to be a top salesperson? And he said, Fripp, I do give you full credit for helping me develop my personality by changing my appearance. So he said, what you say in your story really is absolutely true. Because I helped design the systems, the technology, I knew better than any of the other salespeople how to keep track of inventory, how to keep track of clients. Now, as soon as I developed more confidence and I was more outgoing, it helped me connect with people better. So my results were so good. I sold more out of my little office than some stores sold. Because it was a great combination, you see, of the technology, and he developed the people skills. And he said, they kept wanting to promote me to sales manager. Why would I want to? I'd lose money. What did he do? He took technology, and he added personality and the entrepreneurial flair. And Larry sold more than the salespeople with a great personality, but without the technology.
When you invite me to speak at your conference, my message will be adapted to your industry or event. Other presenters' comments can be incorporated. My message can be delivered as a keynote or a breakout session. Many of my clients hire me to deliver both. Let's have a conversation.